So, how do you deal with changes? I hate changes. Why can't things just always be the same? I have my routine and now everything is destroyed. How often do you hear that from yourself and also from, the people around you? We all hate changes, of course. I think human beings are actually designed to fight against changes because if anything happens, that actually is a danger to our safety. It is a danger to our body, to our environment, to our brain, to our comfort, right? Nobody likes changes. So, how do we deal with changes in life? Sometimes changes are very necessary in order for us to grow, right? For example, I'm wearing glasses. That's a change. I know, I refused for so many years to get a new pair of glasses. I've been wearing glasses for a while, but because I refused to change. And then I realized my eyesight actually changed. So I had to basically go, and evolve with my eyesight as well. So I finally got the new pair. Okay, so there is a famous quote from Robin Sharma. It goes like this: change is hard at first, messy in the middle, but gorgeous at the end. Oh my God, this is so profound, right? It's very true. Whenever there are new changes happening in our environment or whatever it is that we have to do, it's always difficult at the beginning. For example, you have to wake up a lot earlier than usual, right? Your usual wake-up time is, say, 7 o'clock. And then now suddenly you have to wake up at 5 a.m., 2 hours earlier. So, it's so hard. It feels like you're almost killing yourself by crawling out of bed at 5 a.m., right? So it's very hard. And then maybe in the middle, it gets messy, meaning that maybe some days you miss the alarm, some days you get out, some days you fall asleep at work and things like that. But then towards the end, once your body, your whole system is used to it, it becomes gorgeous. It becomes part of your routine, part of your pattern that you don't even think about. So that's just one small example. I'll give you another one of how I actually overcome the changes based on this, hard at first, messy in the middle, and gorgeous at the end. Okay, so a lot of you guys have asked me, how did I get so confident speaking in front of camera? I mean, I'm not perfect, I'm still learning and improving every day. But what I did was 2016, yeah, back in 2016, that's when I decided to go live on Facebook. That's right. When you go live, when a camera goes 3, 2, 1, you have no hesitation, no room to be like, oh, I'm not ready. Let me turn this off and let me do this again. No, once you're live, you are live. And what I have learned is that, obviously I was messy, I mean, I was messy from the beginning. It was hard. I was nervous. I was like, kind of like just talking about everything. And I didn't know what my purpose was, what was the point of me going live and chatting. But then I did it anyway, despite the fact that, I was experiencing all these nervous reactions in my body. But it got messy, of course, because I had to try to do it every day, and I was trying to organize my life, my business, and everything around it. But I still actually was very consistent with it, And I'll tell you, the messy part in the middle was I received some interesting comments. Yes, I mean interesting. So some were negative, some were a bit critical, and some were just very interesting. Like, some people were picking on my choice of food, and some people just said, you should try this, you shouldn't do that, it's wrong. And some people were actually picking on my eyebrows, the way my eyebrows are. So I call this messy because I really pay attention to those comments that people left on my, on my daily video, and I really took them to the heart, and I felt really hurt actually, and I even wanted to argue with them, but at the end I decided to just ignore them. I even consulted some of my friends, like, what should I do about my eyebrows? Isn't that ridiculous? And even I went to complain to my family about some of the people who kind of criticize on my choice of food. I had no intention of say, I'm forcing people to to follow what I do, you know, my diet or my nutrition plan. But, you know, everybody's entitled to their opinions and to their own choices. So I just kind of felt like, oh my God, should I continue doing this or not? You know, not everybody likes what I do. What can I do? I can't please everybody. So it got messy like that. I had to battle with my own choices, and it was only my own battle. I was actually not battling with the people who did not support me. I was battling with the fact that, you know, I could get so defeated so easily just by people's interesting comments, right? But at the end, I decided to ignore them, and I decided to, you know, basically stand firm on my ground and continue punching out daily videos. So it became very gorgeous at the end, meaning that I was actually very used to doing daily live. And when a camera goes 3, 2, 1, I could just speak like, hey, everybody, this is Jane here from Authentic Energy. And today, da 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 da. Right? See, like I can do that just with my eyes closed. It became so like autopilot for me because I was repeating that for 90 days. That's right. If you go back, if you go to my Facebook, you can actually see my daily live video from back in 2016. I did that as a challenge for myself. So for 3 months, continuously every day, I did daily video. So, you know, I did so much. I repeated like for at least 90 times. So I became very, you know, used to it. So, you know, the gorgeous thing is not like, oh, you know, you become perfect at it. You become so, wow, expert at it. Yes, you become better at it. And for anything that you do that you become better, you actually become, you know, confident. So I'll make another episode about how to be confident that actually has a lot to do with practice. So I hope you guys got a lot of values out of what I'm sharing today. Change is hard, but you have to think about, why did you decide to have this change? Why these changes are there in the first place? And then, you know, think about the fact that it will be very gorgeous at the end. Just embrace it. Embrace the messiness. Embrace the difficulties at the beginning. And, you know, look forward to the gorgeous end. You know, when you get that result, when you see the result of your consistent, you know, effort of embracing the change and be part of that change and let the change be part of you. Okay, and when it becomes gorgeous, you know what that means? Time for another change. Dun dun. That's life. Okay, so if you're new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And if you like this video, make sure you give us a big thumbs up. Because this year, I am dedicating my time to making daily videos, daily YouTube videos to inspire you guys to have that body and mind transformation. Okay, so I look forward to, you know, catching up with you guys again next time. All right, ciao.